Hey there, Sharon Horne-Ellstrom here, supersize your business. You can call me Pajama Grandma. In case we haven't met yet, go and put hashtag pajama in the comments below so I know it's the first time you're being exposed to me. Today I want to talk a little bit about your customers and your business and what you do for your customers. And primarily, what problem do you solve for your customers? Do you solve a specific problem for your customers with your products, with your services, with what it is that you do for them? And almost every, well, absolutely every product that exists, every service that exists, it is designed to solve a problem. And if you don't know specifically what problem you're solving or what need you're fulfilling for your customer, and not just any customer, but your most favorite, best, ideal, dream customer, I'm gonna say you're in big trouble, especially in this day and age where information and social media is readily available to everyone. If you're not meeting a specific need for your customer and clearly communicating that to them, if you're not solving an urgent problem for them, you're going to be left in the dust. And if you're not finding a way to communicate with them how you can solve that problem and share the results of other people that you've solved that problem for, again, with the online world and the world moving so fast, you're gonna get left behind. People aren't gonna know about you, and so they're not gonna find you, and your business is gonna suffer instead of thriving and supersizing. So what are some things you can do to determine if you're actually solving a real problem for your customers or not? Well, the quickest, easiest, fastest thing to do is to ask them. Ask them why they do business with you. Ask them about the kinds of results that they're getting. Ask them about what more you could do for them or what else they would like you to provide for them. That is one of the fastest ways of coming up with additional complimentary products to offer to your customers, which increases your bottom line and helps you supersize your business, is by asking your customers what else they need. You can also ask yourself, what is the next logical step? What is the next thing my customers are going to need if I help them solve this particular problem? So say, for example, you're a car dealer and you're selling cars to people. Well, the problem you're solving for them is transportation, getting from point A to point B. It's actually freedom, because having a vehicle allows us to have freedom. So if you are selling someone a car, which is giving them transportation and the freedom to move about their life, maybe it's the freedom to get to and from their job, to provide for their family. What is the next problem that you create for them? Well, maybe it's they need gas for that vehicle. They need maintenance for that vehicle. They need a warranty for that vehicle so that they know it will always be dependable and get them from point A to point B. So now you know a whole slew of things that you can offer your ideal customers in addition to just selling them that one car. And you can create a lifelong relationship with them, which means more money, more resources for you and your organization, more better lifelong customer relationships. So that's it. Think today about, and I'd say grab a piece of paper and write it down. What is the core problem, the basic problem that I solve for my customers? And when I get them to do what I want, like if I sign them up for a coaching contract and I help them solve the major problem in their life, what is the next problem that that creates for them? What is the next problem or that it incorporates into their life? Because if I can give them the solution to that problem, then I already have an upsell opportunity, something else that I can provide for them, which makes them a much more loyal customer. That's it. Go out, make it an awesome day, and I will, of course, be back tomorrow.